and happening, and we'll talk more about it. Meghan Markle is a fresh face in the royal family. The polls are showing the royal family is boosting the UK's reputation. On the leaderboard, as always, the Queen is at the top, but Prince Harry's also there, 23% as most popular, according to a global survey, followed by the Duke and Duchess of Cambridge, that's William and Kate to the rest of us. Joining us now, Kate Williams, the historian and lecturer at the University of London, and Angela Levin, author of Harry, Conversations with the Prince. So, let's start, Angela. Were you surprised it's Prince Charles?
I was a bit. I thought it would be her mother. I thought it would be a show of mother and daughter, a strong relationship. And I thought it would also be that it's women doing it themselves and breaking protocol since Queen Victoria. I was surprised. Then when I heard it was, I thought it was a marvellous gesture of him because he is showing that he's accepting her into the family. And then she decided to walk halfway and
Is it symbolic, do you think? I mean, it wasn't symbolic 2 days ago or last week. Now, all of a sudden, she's walking herself.
It is symbolic, I think. I think it's really very meaningful. And yes, had Thomas Markle not had to have this emergency heart surgery and thrust all of it into uncertainty, we would have expected to see him walking her up the aisle. That was the plan. But of course, he's not here. Things have changed and there has been all this uncertainty. But I do think the fact that she's doing half of it on her own, accompanied by 10 bridesmaids and page boys all under the age of 7, so nothing could go wrong, and then giving herself away, really does suggest that this is a bit of an outdated concept, having your father give you away when you're an independent woman.
I'm choosing my words carefully here, ladies. It's a bit melodramatic, don't you think? It's a bit of drama. I mean, the woman is an actress, yeah. And she has now managed to construct a denouement to the altar.
Yeah, I don't think it's a sort of act of giving yourself away, whether your father does it or whether you do it. You just join someone. I think the giving away still is harking back to the time where you expect your husband to support you, you expect him to be in the lead.
Right.
But I just think you can go down there whichever way you want to and say, here I am.
I'm more interested in the mother meeting the Queen for tea today.
Yes, the mother met the Queen for tea today. We heard it was a very successful meeting. Harry and Meghan were also there. But we believe that the ultimate seal of approval was that the Queen was seen leaving Windsor with Meghan's beloved dog. So clearly, we know that the corgis love Meghan. So the fact that the Queen has now seems to have adopted Meghan's dog as a chum, well, there's nothing more that can be gained. She's clearly the Queen's favourite. And there they are walking in to Clifton House, the first house of Nancy Astor, the first woman in Parliament. That's a beautiful hotel.
And it's expensive. It's very expensive.
Well, money's no object on this wedding, is it, really?
It's very...
I mean, we expect an expensive wedding dress. We expect everything will be done in great style and with no expense spared, I think.
How important is... Are we overstating, Angela, to you first? Are we overstating the importance of Meghan Markle to the royal family?
I don't think we are, actually. I think it's extraordinary where she's come from, you know, quite a humble home, quite dysfunctional. She's not at all what you would imagine the royal consort would be. And yet she's climbed her own way up. She's very self-made. She's not an aristocrat who would just do a bit of work on a glossy magazine. She's really worked hard to get known. And I think it is extraordinary. I think the length of time they've known each other is very short. Extraordinary as well. And that she is very powerful and she wants to speak her own way and do what she wants.
How is she going to get on, not just with the royal family, but with the bunch of friends, the arguably, some would say, entitled, both titled and entitled people with whom the circles that they mix. She's a working woman who has worked her way up into a very hard career.
She is a working woman. She's self-made. We believe she's made herself something in the vicinity of $10 million, which is incredible. And yes, once upon a time, Prince Harry and Prince William were surrounded by a party group of young men and young women who didn't really do much, who were rather...
The Honourable's this and the Honourable's that.
Going to discos in London, I mean, that was... But a lot of them have changed and grown up. And they initially, they did not accept Kate. They didn't like her. They called her doors to manual.
Waiting.
refer to the fact that her mother was an air steward. That's a perfectly respectable job. They said that they called her doors to manual, but they got over their snobbery. And I think it's time to realise that the middle classes, of which I am one, and people who work for a living, it is time that the royal family incorporates them. And so we think about who could George marry? I think another working woman.
I think if you look at Charles and Diana, the royal family was searching far and wide to find someone suitable that he would marry. And she had to be aristocratic, she had to be a virgin, she had to come from a good family. That hasn't been essential here, that hasn't happened here. I think it's extraordinary that both men have chosen women they wanted, who were middle class, and suit them.
Right. Let's talk about the Queen and what she's making of all of this. I mean, a woman who was founded on the abdication, with the searing memory of that, all the scandals from Suez to Margaret to toe-sucking to Diana to Philip and all the various things, nothing phases the Queen.
I think it does deep down, but she doesn't show it. She's a stiff upper lip generation, and whatever happens, duty comes first, so she can swallow all that. I think she's got softer, particularly since Prince Philip, her husband, has taken a step back, because he's the one who likes absolute detail, and she's got a bit softer. And since her own mother died, she would never have worn these bright colours, so I've been told, that she's been wearing lately. If her mother was around, she wouldn't have thought it was suitable. I think she's got more relaxed about things.
So, finally, what should I be watching out for tomorrow, bearing in mind that I'm not going to get terribly excited by the dress?
Okay, well,
so what moment?
I think the big moment is when we see all of the royal family in the chapel, the Queen, and of course so many of her relatives are buried there, her mother and father, and we see the moment when Harry sees Meghan for the first time. He hasn't seen the dress, many of the people have, and we'll see, I think, the love between them then.
I think so as well. It would be the dress. A lot of men, when they look round, they see their bride. They can't believe how beautiful they look. And they're glowing. They're looking at their absolute best. They're incredibly happy. There's emotion in the air. And I think we'll
You're
see
both
something.
Basically politely telling me that I'm a miserable old thing.
Do you know my favourite tweet?
Go on.
There was my favourite tweet. Someone saying, Prince Harry's engagement to Meghan Markle gave black women hope. And someone had retweeted it saying, his engagement to a beautiful woman gave ginger men hope. And as a ginger woman, I can say that. But just think, every ginger man across the world and ginger woman, we can have a beautiful person too.
Wonderful to
Thank
have you with us tonight.
Thank
Looking
you so
forward
much.
To working
Thank
with you,
you
tomorrow. As we continue tonight here on Crest Means Business, there is so much more royal interest, royal intrigue, royal story. It is Crest Means Business, and we are in business in Windsor. Yep.